It's difficult for any player to go down with an injury, let alone one who is expected to be a vital part of your offense. But with Gabe Watson battling a nagging hamstring, redshirt sophomore Thuro Reisdorfer and redshirt freshman Ja’Tai Jenkins have filled in admirably, trying to make up for lost production.
I feel like every day you practice, you got to be ready. And you know, that guy might go down and you got to be ready to take those carries.
We all work out together. We all do everything together. So when somebody goes down, next man right up, that's the mentality. You know, we all study together. We all know what's going on. And, you know, that's just how we succeed as a team.
Thuro and Ja’Tai have received the bulk of the carries in Gabe's absence, showcasing their ability to make plays and keep defenses guessing.
They're really dependable kids. So you put them in there and it's not a reduced playbook in any stretch. They're going to go out and execute and play extremely hard and then do what they need to do.
I say I'm more of a speed, elusive type of back. Thuro's really, you know, broad shoulders and all that, trying to get north and south. Me, I feel like I'm just like the guy you want to get in space, make a guy miss and get upfield.
I'm still going to go day in and day out the same I've been going, you know. Nothing's really changed. I work for it every day. So I'm just going to stick to the game plan and everything will work out.
Gabe Watson's presence on the field may be missing, but his influence is everywhere.
Ever since he came here, I've been watching his style and taking little things from him and listening to what he says because I know he's a good football player.
Gabe's always the last person out the weight room. He's always doing extra, and he's always pushing us as running backs to do extra. And, you know, that's what makes him special.
Thuro and Ja’Tai don't need to be special for the Cougars to stay competitive. They just need to work hard, and both of them understand what's expected.
I'm just ready for it. I mean, I'm just trying to be a dependable guy, and if I got to step up, that's what I got to do.
I feel like I have my own specific role on this team, and I'm bound to play it. I'm not looking for 100 reps, 30 carries. I don't need all that. I'm just looking to do my job, you know, and make the team successful.
That's a great thing that we're seeing is that maturity, where they're able to play at a high level. Both of them are involved on special teams as well, so they're doing things that all throughout the football game, and, you know, thrilled to have those guys on our side for multiple years to come.
The goals for USF haven't changed. A return to the playoffs is expected after missing out in 2018. The journey may be difficult, but for head coach John Anderson, seeing two underclassmen step up in the absence of a senior leader requires just four easy words.
Impressed, yes. Surprised, no.
There's no motivation needed. They're going to go out and they're going to play for their brothers and they're going to do things right and they're going to put it all out there. Right, wrong, or indifferent, they're going to put it all out there.